Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Rogers Kakasungura YouTube channel. It's a Thursday morning. I hope you've woken up wherever you are. And those from Joy Biden, I hope your night is faring on well. Let me, before I proceed to today's analysis, I want to take you back to 2021. You know, in Kenya, we have a tendency of using the police to intimidate and scare those who do not agree with those in power. Those who have divergent opinion, those with authority, use excessive power through the police to scare and intimidate the people they suspect of having divergent or having different plans than the ones from those in authority. We witnessed Friday arrests during the Uhuru regime. Even William Ruto himself faced such threats to an extent where he stood in the public and told Uhuru Kenyatta, usitumie polisi kutunyanyasa. Kwa nini? Freedom is coming. William Ruto, William Ruto, who swore to the Bible and told Kenyans that once he assumes as the president, he will never use police to intimidate critics. Yani, aliapa akisema kwamba, akiwa rais wa taifa la Kenya, hakuna siku hatatumia polisi kuwanyanyasa wale ambao wana maoni tofauti na yale yake kama rais wa taifa la Kenya. Alizungumza haya. Alianena kanisani, akazungumza akifanyiwa mahojiano katika vyombo vya habari. And so many other platforms where he raised those concerns. I hope you even watched those videos. The same script that William Ruto went through is the very same script William Ruto is applying on Rigathi Gachagua. And according to the information, is that two UDA members of parliament who are allied to the deputy president were arrested over claims that they are the ones who were involved in sponsoring the Gen Z anti-government protests. They were arrested. Imagine, members of parliament from UDA party in the Kenya Kwanza government, but because they are affiliated to Rigathi Gachagua, they were arrested. Is Gachagua harvesting or reaping what he had planted in 2022? Je, Gachagua anavuna aliyoyapanda? Kwa sababu, I remember very well, is among the people who used to sing, freedom is coming. Maybe this is the type of freedom he was talking about. The two members of parliament were released yesterday after they were grilled over the alleged involvement in sponsoring the recent anti-government demonstrations that have been witnessed across the country. The Embakasi North MP James Gakuya and Embakasi Central Member of Parliament Benjamin Gathiru were put to task to explain the sources of their wealth. And according to the information, they were arrested 2 days ago for grilling. And in all those 2 days, they have been under grilling. Hey! in Kenya, according to the sources close to the information, the two were arrested on Monday evening while spending their time in one of the hotels. That is where they were arrested from, within the Nairobi CBD. So walishikwa Jumatatu. The whole of that Monday, they were being grilled. The whole of Tuesday, they were being grilled. And the better part of yesterday, they were being grilled. And they were released yesterday after recording statements. According to a close friend to them, he says, there is no evidence at all whatsoever that can be produced by the DCI to defend their arrests. The police have no evidence. They can't substantiate that they are the people or the office of the deputy president is the one that is behind the sponsoring of the maandamano. But I thought, mimi nilifikiria kwamba maandamano yalikuwa sponsored na Ford Foundation. What changed? Kenya kuna mambo. Tuliambiwa, we were being told in public. Rais akasimama mwenyewe. Akasema, the people behind the funding of the chaos and anarchy in the Republic of Kenya is the Ford Foundation. Lakini kwa sababu baadaye Rachel Ruto alipatikana kuwa mmoja wa wale ambao wamepokea pesa kutoka foundation, it's like Ruto chickened out of that issue. Kulingana na mimi, it's like Ruto thought is going to throw some organizations out of balance, but little did he know even his wife, the first lady, has been receiving money from the Ford Foundation. Meaning, maybe Ruto realized that the trajectory is directing this propaganda will not sell, and in fact, it will affect him more. Because the wife has been receiving millions of shillings from the same Ford Foundation. So if the Ford is the sponsor of the maandamano, the wife becomes part and parcel of those people with funds sponsoring maandamano. But that has been buried. Now, we are being told that the office of the deputy president could be the one involved in sponsoring the chaos. And that is why the people around Rigiji are being intimidated. Tukaambiwa ni LGBTQ by the government spokesperson. Tukaambiwa ni Illuminati. Walipotoka Illuminati, wakasema ni Mount Kenya tycoons. Walipotoka kwa Mount Kenya tycoons, ya juzi, wakasema ni Ford Foundation. Wametoka kwa Ford Foundation, the most latest, wanasema ni watu ambao wako katika ofisi ya deputy president, ndio wanapeleka vijana katika maandamano. Surely, serikali iko na midomo miwili. Mchana inaongea kutoka east, usiku inaongea from west. Confusion gallo. Ladies and gentlemen, vijana wametangaza maandamano ya 8-8-8. Tarehe 8 mwezi wa 8 mwaka 2024. Sisi tuko hapa. Our work is to give you information. And the information I give here is not owned by Kakasungura. I am just a vessel to pass information to you so that you be aware. It is your constitutional right to be informed. It is your right and no one can take away that right. So when I'm informing you here, it is 100% your right to be informed. God bless you. See you in the next video. Asanteni sana.